Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to St. Mary's Cathedral. My name's Thomas Wilson. I'm the director of music here at St. Mary's, and it's my job this afternoon to help all of us here to sing God's praises in this special confirmation mass. Now, in any mass, the most important type of music is what we call responsorial. That's when the priest, or in this case, the archbishop, sings something and the whole congregation sings back in response. That's the very beginning of all church music, not hymns or organ playing or choirs. It's that response that comes back to the celebrant, and it's all the more beautiful when it is sung. So what do we do in an occasion like today when we have people coming from lots of different parishes that all might know different hymns and songs? Well, we've designed very simple responsorial music that we hope we'll all be able to sing together. So you should all have one of these booklets, and if you would turn to page 5, you'll see where it says Order of Mass, the processional chant. So as the bishops process towards the sanctuary, we sing this first piece of music, and it has a very simple line for us all to respond to. I'll sing it once, and then we'll all sing it together.
I will give you a new heart. I will put a new spirit within you.
Let's sing that together.
I will give you a new heart. I will put a new spirit within you.
Let's turn on. The next piece of music is the Lord Have Mercy at the bottom of page 6. Very simple indeed. And the cantor will sing each line and then you sing it back. It's so easy, we don't need to look at it now. I suspect that a lot of us will know the Gloria refrain, which goes like this.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
And I can see some of you singing along, so I'm pleased. That means that that one should be a hit. I look forward to hearing you raise the roof with the Gloria. Then on page 8, the response to the responsorial psalm. Again, I'll sing it to you, and then we'll all sing it together.
Send forth your spirit, O Lord, and renew the face of the earth.
Your turn.
Send forth your spirit, O Lord, and renew the face of the earth.
When we're trying to come up with all this simple responsorial music, there are various types of melodies that are so common in all types of music that we hope that some of these things will sound like you know them, even though you might be singing them here for the first time. And that's one of those. Turning on a few pages over on page 13, you'll see where it says the Liturgy of the Eucharist. And there's a piece of music that we sing together whilst the gifts are being prepared on the altar, the offertory chant. It sounds like this.
Confirm in us, O God, the good that you have done. We make ourselves an offering to you.
Let's sing that together and go.
Confirm in us, O God, the good that you have done. We make ourselves an offering to you.
And like lots of the music in this afternoon's Mass, that refrain will keep coming back and again during the offertory. And our cantor, Josie, who you'll hear and see in just a few moments, will sing the verses. At the bottom of the page, there's the dialogue that we sing with the Archbishop himself. This is one of those most important moments I mentioned at the beginning. So when he sings,
the Lord be with you,
we all sing,
and with your spirit.
He sings, lift up your hearts. We sing,
we lift them up to the Lord.
He sings,
let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
And we respond,
it is right and just.
Turning over one more page, on page 14, you'll see the Holy Holy. Now we've designed the Holy Holy and the Lamb of God to be very similar. So once you've got the idea in the Holy Holy, it should be possible also to sing the Lamb of God. I'll sing you the first line of music in the Holy Holy, and then we'll repeat it. So I'll quickly sing it to you and then we might try it together.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Your turn.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Can make or break a celebration. And so the onus is on all of us. Although our cantor Josie has a stunning voice, she's an amazing singer, it's not her job alone. It's something that we all do together. So I look forward to us all singing the parts of the Mass as well as we can as part of our participation in the Eucharist. Thank you very much.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to this celebration of the Sacrament of Confirmation for parishes of the Eastern Deanery. I decided this year to invite you to my place, so our young people might have a truly memorable confirmation ceremony and might experience the bigger church, that family of families, that community of parish communities, that is the Archdiocese of Sydney. I acknowledge and celebrating with me Auxiliary Bishops Terry, Tony and Richard, and Fathers Laurie, Bernie and Moses. I welcome all the sponsors and families, teachers and catechists who are with us today. And to all of you, my young friends, who will be receiving this sacrament this afternoon, I say a very warm welcome. Dear brothers and sisters, the sacraments of baptism and confirmation call us to be saints for our world at this time. So we first repent of the times we failed to live as saints. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Christ have mercy, Christ. A reading from the book of Isaiah. The Lord says this, "Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom my soul delights. I have endowed him with the Spirit, that he may bring true justice to the nations. He does not cry out or shout aloud, or make his voice heard in the streets. He does not break the crushed reed, nor quench the wavering flame. Faithfully, he brings true justice." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
to the Galatians. If you are guided by the Spirit, you will be in no danger of yielding to self-indulgence, since self-indulgence is the opposite of the Spirit. The Spirit is totally against such a thing, and it is precisely because the two are so opposed that you do not always carry out your good intentions. What the Spirit brings is very different. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. You cannot belong to Christ Jesus unless you crucify all self-indulgent passions and desires. Since the Spirit is our life, let us be directed by the Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "If anyone wants to be a follower of mine, let him renounce himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who wants to save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake will find it. What then will a man gain if he wins the whole world and ruins his life? Or what has a man to offer in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man is going to come in the glory of his Father and with his angels. And when he does, he will reward each one according to his behavior." The Gospel of the Lord.
Your Grace, the parents of each candidate and the parish priests present these candidates for the sacrament of confirmation and testify that they have been prepared and are ready to receive the sacrament of confirmation. We request that you confer these candidates the sacrament of confirmation.
Baptism is obviously about washing. A special washing, of course, by which our old sinful nature is cleansed and we are given a fresh start, our beginning experience of grace, faith, church, saints. Holy Communion is fairly obvious too. It's about eating. A special eating, of course, as we participate in Jesus' Last Supper, when he gave his all, even his body and blood, to be part of us. Reconciliation is about forgiving, but a special forgiving that reconciles us to God, each other, ourselves. Matrimony and holy orders are about committing, giving ourselves to each other in service as man and wife, man and church, and being received and loved in return. Holy anointing is obviously about healing, caring for the sick of body or soul, and bringing a promise of eternity. We can make sense of all these sacraments because they are like things we do in ordinary life. Washing and eating, loving and forgiving, curing and caring. But confirmation, that's a hard one to explain, as perhaps some of the parents here today have found it themselves. It's a hard one even for a bishop. Well, today I want to suggest confirmation is the sacrament that renews and promises all the other sacraments, all at once. Let me explain. Baptism is the sacrament of beginning, initiation, foundation. But so is confirmation. It gets you going. Jesus sent his disciples out to tell his story, to be his loving heart and hands, reaching out to all, especially to those most in need. To make that possible, he sent the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, so they'd have the wisdom and courage they needed. I've endowed my servant with my spirit, says the Lord in our first reading, so he can bring true justice to the nations. Without that push, that empowerment we call grace, we wouldn't dare do such things. But with them, even 10 and 11-year-olds on the cusp of Christian adulthood can share Jesus with the world around them. So confirmation is a bit like rewashing and resending, a second baptism. Like Eucharist, however, confirmation is a sacrament of connecting and communing. At Pentecost, people couldn't understand each other's languages. Then the Holy Spirit came and they could. Eucharist is like that too. Here in Sydney, it brings people from every background to celebrate one faith, hope, and love. We receive Christ's body so we might be united with him and together become his body, the Church. As the Holy Spirit does to the bread, so he does to our young people. Confirmation is like First Communion all over again, as Christ gives himself to you and you give yourself to him to be changed. But things fall apart. We've got big ideals, but sometimes we don't live up to them. We've got important relationships, but sometimes we let each other down. We've got God in our lives, but sometimes we neglect or disobey him. How to get back together with our ideals, people, God? Through confession, that sacrament too often neglected and now attacked in some places. There the priest reminds us that God sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. And by that Spirit's power, says, I absolve you from your sins. At the first Pentecost, the apostles were healed of their betrayal, their cowardice, their confusion, and restored to friendship with God and each other. So confirmation today is like re-forgiveness. Second, reconciliation. But confirmation is also like marriage and ordination, because it's about commitment. We give ourselves to God, our highest ideals, the service of humanity. We say to our family, our friends, our church, the human race, I am yours, all yours, for better or worse, for richer or poorer. I am an adult Christian now, ready to commit to big things. But will I see them through? Only by God's grace. So confirmation is like pre-ordination, pre-marriage. It gets us ready for more and better loving. But like our final anointing, confirmation is a sacrament of completion. We use oil today at the beginning of our adult life in confirmation. But we use it also at the end, in anointing. Oil massages, soothes, embalms. So whatever is hurting in your life, torn, broken, bring that to the Holy Spirit for healing. Already in your young lives, my friends, there is room for mending. There will be more bumps and bruises ahead. But any time you experience hurt in your body or heart, call upon the Holy Spirit. Confirmation is his promise that he will be there for you when hard times come and get you through hardships, sickness, even death. The Holy Spirit comes again and again, through word and sacrament, and especially today in confirmation. When you are sealed with the Holy Spirit, he promises you, my young friends, fruits like love, joy, and peace, patience, kindness, and goodness, trustfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And he promises to be with you always, in everything you do. With his gifts, like wisdom and courage, you will do great things. And so, my young friends, there is a lot packed into this sacrament of confirmation. God wants to give all this to you because he loves you so much and has big plans for you. Take part wholeheartedly in the rest of the Christian life, and you'll be amazed what can happen in you, with you, and for you. My fellow clergy, sponsors, teachers, and catechists, family and friends of our candidates, today our candidates will receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Help them apply those gifts in lives of Christian faith and practice, of virtue and holiness, of the worship of God, and love for all. Candidates for confirmation, when you are anointed today, you will receive all you need to lead an adult Christian life, a life of loving and forgiving, curing and caring, communing and inspiring. It's a big task, but a wonderful one. And I know you can do this big thing. You can do so by praying, coming to Mass and confession, learning more about your faith, and doing good things in our world. The Holy Spirit will make all this possible. So now I invite you who are to be confirmed to stand up and profess your faith before this assembly. And since it is a Sunday, I invite you all to stand and join our young people in professing their faith. And so I ask you all, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who today, through the sacrament of confirmation, is given to you in a special way, just as he was given to the apostles on the day of Pentecost?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Would the candidates only remain standing, please? Dearly beloved, let us pray to God the Almighty Father for these his adopted sons and daughters, already born again to eternal life in baptism, that he will graciously pour out the Holy Spirit upon them and confirm them with his abundant gifts, and through his anointing conform them more fully to Christ, the Son of God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who brought these your servants to new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, freeing them from sin, send upon them, O Lord, the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and fortitude, the spirit of knowledge and piety. Fill them with the spirit of the fear of the Lord, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you. Please stand. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly pray to God, the Almighty Father, and be of one mind in our prayer, just as faith, hope, and charity which proceed from his Holy Spirit are one.
For these his servants, whom the gift of the Holy Spirit has confirmed, that, planted in faith and grounded in love, they may bear witness to Christ the Lord by their way of life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their parents and sponsors, that by word and example, they may continue to encourage those whom they have sponsored in their faith to follow in the footsteps of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who prepared them for this sacrament, that the Spirit of knowledge may continue to work through them in their mission, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Holy Church of God, together with Francis our Pope, Anthony our Bishop, and all the bishops, that, gathered by the Holy Spirit, the Church may grow and increase in unity of faith and love until the coming of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole world, that all people who have one Maker and Father may acknowledge one another as brothers and sisters without discrimination of race or nation, and with sincere hearts seek the kingdom of God, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For our communities, that the Spirit of wisdom and understanding may help us to welcome and adore Jesus, the bread of life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
O God, who gave the Holy Spirit to your apostles and willed that through them and their successors the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the faithful, listen favourably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, may now spread through the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of the Lord, for our good and the good of all the Church.
Receive in your mercy, O Lord, the prayers of your servants, and grant that, being conformed more perfectly to your Son, they may grow steadily in bearing witness to him, as they share in the memorial of his redemption, by which he gained for us your Holy Spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, ascending above all the heavens and sitting at your right hand, he poured out the promised Holy Spirit on your adopted children. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the host of angels, we sing to you with all our hearts, crying out as we acclaim. Give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us the eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Mary of the Cross MacKillop, and all the saints our confirmandi have chosen this day, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Anthony our Bishop, his auxiliaries Terry, Richard, me your unworthy servant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Remember also, Lord, your servants reborn in baptism, whom you have been pleased to confirm by bestowing the Holy Spirit, and in your mercy keep safe in them your grace. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and for my divine teaching, we dare to say, sin and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the King.
Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to shelter under my roof, but you say the word of my soul.
Let us pray. Accompany your blessing from this day forward, O Lord. Those who have been anointed with the Holy Spirit and nourished by the sacrament of your Son, so that with all trials overcome, they may gladden your church by their holiness, and through their works and their charity, foster her growth in the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Good afternoon, everyone. Archbishop Anthony, Bishop Terry, Bishop Tony, and Bishop Richard, candidates, sponsors, families, and friends. Today, a memory has been etched into our minds forever. We've been fortunate enough to receive the gifts and the fruits of the Holy Spirit as a group of young Catholics coming together to celebrate our confirmation, bonding us forever. The gifts and the fruits have been sent to us by God to be used in the right way so we can live like Christ. We pray they grow stronger each day as we put our faith in God and the Holy Spirit. And now on behalf of all the candidates, sponsors, families and friends, here today at St. Mary's, we would like to thank you, Archbishop Anthony, Bishop Terry, Bishop Tony and Bishop Richard, for helping us complete our journey in the Sacrament of Confirmation, and ask that you accept these cards as a token of our appreciation. Thank you.
Once again, we wish to thank His Grace, Bishop Terry, Bishop Richard, and Bishop Tony. It has been a wonderful experience celebrating this very special sacrament at St. Mary's Cathedral. Just a reminder to all parents, please note all confirmed candidates will be dismissed from the crypt. Once Mass has concluded, all confirmed candidates and sponsors will follow His Grace and bishops down the aisle and turn right to make their way down to the crypt. Candidates are to have their name marked off in the crypt before being dismissed. Parents and families, we ask you to please remain seated, and once all the children and sponsors have left the cathedral, you may exit by the side doors and make your way down to the external entrance of the crypt to collect your child. Thank you.
If I might add my own word of thanks to those we've just heard, to thank everyone who contributed to this beautiful celebration today, those who've recently been preparing our children for this day, and especially to the families who've been preparing them these last 10 or 11 years for this day. Baptism, Holy Communion and Confirmation now complete one chapter of the book of our young people's lives, their initiation into the family of God. And now we open a new chapter, their lives as Christian adults. You'll find they need you every bit as much as they did in the first chapter, perhaps in some ways more. Keep giving them the example of your own faith and practice, your own desire to be saints, your own virtuous action in our world. May God bless all the families and especially our newly confirmed, whom we congratulate now. The Lord be with you.
Bow down for the blessing.
May God the Father Almighty bless you, whom he has made his adopted sons and daughters, reborn from water and the Holy Spirit, and may he keep you worthy of his fatherly love.
Amen.
May his only begotten Son, who promised that the Spirit of truth would abide in his church, bless you and confirm you by his power in the confession of the true faith.
Amen.
And may the Holy Spirit, who kindles the fire of charity in the hearts of disciples, bless you and lead you blameless and gathered as one into the joy of the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you who are gathered here, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.